Welcome back to Star Trek Nitpickers, everybody. I'm your host, Commander Corbo. And hey, today we're talking about my old friend, Bortus. And here's your co-host, Acting Ensign William.
Thanks a lot, Commander Corbo. So, Bortus on the Orville is a fan favorite. He's a great guy. He's a Mauklin from the planet Mauklus, and he's the second officer on the Orville, which means he's third in command of the ship. Mauklins are an almost entirely male species that lay eggs to reproduce. This aspect of the species may remind Trek fans of a species that is entirely male, the Jem'Hadar, who also have an unusual means of reproduction.
So what do? Lay eggs?
Jem'Hadar are bred in birthing chambers.
This isn't all too different from how the Kalon reproduce on a central production facility, sort of like a giant assembly line. Mauklins are a lot cooler than the Jem'Hadar, though, from a human starship captain's point of view, anyway. Mauklins are members of the Union, while the Jem'Hadar are always talking about destroying the Federation. Bortus is actually named after a Klingon ship that came to the aid of the Enterprise in the Next Gen episode, The Defector. Worf was actually the tactical officer on the Bortus in another episode, Redemption, when he left Starfleet to fight alongside Gowron. Now, Seth MacFarlane is a huge Next Gen fan, but he may have named the Bortus after the other Klingon ship by the same name seen a century earlier in Scott Bakula's series Star Trek Enterprise. After all, MacFarlane appeared on that show as an extra. Well, he did have a line or two. MacFarlane recently divulged Norm MacDonald's character, Yaphet, is named after Yaphet Kotto. Seth said he was watching the Bond film with Kotto while he was writing the pilot. So Yaphet on the Orville is spelled Y-A-P-H-I-T. The actor's name is spelled Y-A-P-H-E-T. Now, Bortus in the Orville is B-O-R-T-U-S. The Klingon ship is spelled B-O-R-T-A-S. So Seth likes to change one letter to make it his own. Mauklins remind me of Klingons much more than the Jem'Hadar, really, and Bortus in particular has some interesting similarities with everybody's favorite Klingon, Worf. For one thing, they both like to sing. Another thing they have in common, they both have cast iron stomachs. Bortus eats a whole ball of that super spicy green Japanese wasabi mustard that comes with sushi, and his only response when everybody freaks out is, "I am feeling no discomfort." He then goes on to explain that Mauklins have evolved to be able to extract nutrients from a wide variety of organic and inorganic materials due to their planet's harsh climate. Worf will eat pretty much anything you put down in front of him, as seen in the episode Time Squared, where no one wants to eat the eggs Riker picked up on Starbase 73 after they try the first bite. Worf can't get enough, though, calling the omelet delicious and scarfing it down.
"I want eggs now."
Worf's favorite drink is prune juice. I don't know if you've ever had prune juice, but it's not easy to drink too much of it. It's extremely bitter, but when Guinan first introduces Worf to the drink, he acts like he's just found the Sword of Kaelas, exclaiming upon tasting it,
"Warrior's drink."
"Oh, very clever, Worf. Eat any good books lately?"
Like Worf, Bortus seems to ask for a lot of time off to deal with family matters. The first time, it's because he needs time to sit on his egg. Captain Mercer makes a string of bad jokes, and when they all completely fail to land with Bortus, Mercer gives up and says, "You know, I'm just not going to try humor with you anymore." Bortus is a stern dude, much like Worf. However, they do both have a sense of humor. We find out in the episode Priya that Bortus is a fan of slapstick comedy. The next time we see Bortus needing some time to put his family life in order, he's diverting the whole ship to his home planet, much like Worf in Sins of the Father. Bortus needs to deal with the fact that his egg hatched a girl instead of the desired boy, and the Mauklin authorities want to make sure she's given a sex change as soon as possible. At first, Bortus agrees with Mauklin tradition, but then he gets his mind changed by Gordon and Lamar. He needs someone to be what the Mauklins call an advocate and represent him in the Mauklin court, what they call a tribunal, and so he asks Captain Mercer to basically be his lawyer. In the episode of Star Trek Enterprise, where we see the earlier version of the Bortus ship, an episode called Judgment Rites, we also hear Klingons use the word tribunal and advocate to mean basically the same thing as the Mauklins. Both Mauklin and Klingon courts are fairly totalitarian and Kafkaesque, and not the kind of thing you'd want to find yourself caught up in. In the Next Gen episode Sins of the Father, Worf asks his captain to be his chadich in the Klingon court proceedings. A chadich is similar to a lawyer, but instead of arguing on your behalf, a chadich fights on your behalf with a sword.
Who said the pen's mightier than the sword, huh?
That would be Edward Bulwer Lytton, Commander Corbo, back in 1839. Now, in 2367, Picard ends up going off alone on Worf's homeworld and finding an old woman, Kalest, whose testimony could change everything in Worf's legal dispute. Captain Mercer actually turns Bortus down when it comes to representing him in court, stating Kelly would be much better suited for the job. Captain Mercer ends up going off with a full away team on Bortus's homeworld and scrounging up an old woman, Havina, whose testimony changes everything. Both Bortus and Worf's cases have far-reaching implications for their respective people, and both nearly change the course of the civilizations in question. When Havina, aka Gondis Eldon, brings to light the fact that the planet's greatest writer, her, is a woman, it clearly has an enormous impact on all the Mauklins in the room. If the court had been a little more moved by her testimony, they may have allowed Bortus to forego the sex change of his daughter. Even without the court agreeing to drop the matter, the fact that Gondis Eldon, one of the most respected of all Mauklins, is a woman, is out, and one can only imagine the ripple effect it will have on the society. In The Next Generation, Kalest isn't even permitted to testify, and Worf ends up accepting discommendation and getting kicked out of the Klingon Empire in order to prevent a civil war that would ensue if the truth about his case came out. In both instances, something deeply personal involving the family life of the character in question becomes the subject of a legal dispute, the outcome of which could change the world as they know it. Okay, so another thing Bortus and Worf have in common. They're both in love with Deanna Troi.
For the assuaging of depression, Rocky Road is most consumed.
I wish to eat Rocky Road.
Transfer the letters from my mother. I would like a real chocolate sundae.
Chocolate ice cream, chocolate fudge, and chocolate chips. You're not depressed, are you?
Using chocolate and or ice cream to cheer yourself up was a bit of a habit of ship's counselor Deanna Troi. Clyden has it for breakfast, she had it for dinner. Of course, one of Bortus's best episodes is the third one, called About a Girl, where he goes back and forth on whether or not to give his newborn a sex change. It's reminiscent of a Deep Space Nine episode called The Muse, in which another Troi, Loxana Troi, Deanna's mother, wants to avoid a custom of her new husband's people. He's a Tavinian, and it's important to his people that male children be raised by the father and never meet the mother until the age of 16. Females are raised by the mother and don't meet the father until 16. Loxana is dead set against handing her son over to her husband. Bortus cares a lot about his family and about family matters in general, much like Mr. Worf. Unlike Worf, Bortus is lucky enough to have a mate who's agreed to live with him on an alien starship. Mauklins are members of the Union, like Klingons are members of the Federation, but we see a lot more humans than Mauklins on the Orville. Bortus, like Worf, is the only one of his kind on the bridge. Bortus' greatest fear is being defeated by a superior adversary. That's sort of a fear of Worf's, but it's also sort of what he craves the most. Dying at the hands of a superior enemy would be an honorable death in Worf's eyes and would secure him a place in Stovo Kor. So the big question on everybody's mind, who would win in a fight? Bortus or Worf? They both place a high premium on combat skills. They both like to fight with their mates in combat simulators. Worf always had to deal with the fact that Data was way stronger than him. Bortus not only has Isaac, he also has Alara to mess with his head. So far, we haven't really seen Bortus throw a sword around or practice martial arts, so I'm gonna have to go with Worf. What do you guys think? So you may recall that the last episode of the first season of The Orville was actually cut. Now, nobody knows why this happened exactly, but the rumor was that Fox felt the show had already performed so well and been such a success that they might as well push that episode to the next season and give them a head start with that season. Now, I don't know if that's true or not, but the rumor was also that that episode focused on Bortus and his child Tova. So, let me know what you would like to see happen with the Happy Family, and let me know if you guys have any cool ideas for videos that I should be doing about the Orville or about Star Trek. And please, take a chance, take a minute, and hit the subscribe button, and we'll keep our comm link open and we'll stay in touch. Please have a great day, and please, live long and prosper.